Hey everyone, this is Squallsnake, editor-in-chief of mygamer.com and blogger at squallsnake.com. And today I am going to be showing something a little more unique. This is a Game Boy Color game with a rumble pack in it. So I've recently been acquiring weird cartridges, you know, more obscure Game Boy cartridges. And I've almost at this point, at the time of this video, have almost the entire US set of rumble cartridges. So what is this? Why is it obscure? Why maybe should you care? So, and there are 16 US release games that came with a built-in rumble pack. This is actually it right here. You can see it says rumble on the back, and there it is right there. It actually spins, and I'll show you that in a second here. So the cartridge itself is bigger than a standard Game Boy cartridge. So before we plug this in and get started, I just want to show off the box and how it separates itself from other Game Boy games on the market. And that's this little symbol right here. It includes the rumble feature. If you look on the back, let's get ready to rumble, 10 fighters. This game in particular is only for Game Boy Color. It will work on Game Boy Advance systems. And if you can see right there, it says contains built-in rumble feature, and this does run on one AAA battery, and one was included at the time. So, and it's made by Crawfish and of course Midway. So let's take a quick look at the instruction manual, just because I bought this game complete, and it kind of just goes over everything in the instructions. And here it very specifically talks about the rumble pack, and it's PAK. I don't know why Nintendo spells things a little weird, but I kind of like it in a way. So here is the instruction, just kind of goes over everything and nothing too in depth about the rumble pack other than that one page. So how this works is this rumble motor just pops down, and then the battery case comes right off, and then here is your one AAA battery. So normally the Game Boy runs on two AA's, but in order to get the rumble to work, you do need one AAA battery. So this right here, this is a bitch. So these things get lost all the time because they're kind of flimsy. As you can see, it's just these little hooks that kind of connect in there, and it just kind of fits into the slot and it snaps into place. But if you ever see these out in the wild, chances are, unfortunately, you're going to find this without the case, without the battery case. It's not the end of the world. The battery will not pop out during gameplay or anything, but it's just unfortunate. It just kind of doesn't look right, and it just kind of bothers me, being a somewhat of a collector of obscure game stuff. So let's put this in. I am going to be playing this on a modded Game Boy Color with a backlit screen, so I hope the video will be able to pick up on this. So I'm going to kind of shut up here, because you, in the beginning, you get to see the rumble and you get to hear, let's get ready to rumble. I don't want to blow it, but ruin it here. Ready to rumble, 1999. It's coming, I swear. Hold on. All right, so I hope you can see that, but right here, this is the rumble. And the game opens up with, let's get ready to rumble, and it shakes, which is kind of a cool feature, actually. So with all the games that I've been playing, no other game kind of intros with the rumble. So there is a demo mode, which is kind of cool. All right, so I am going to press start. You can turn the rumble on or off from the options menu, here's the options menu, but rumble right from the main menu. I'm just going to play this on easy, and one knockdown, 5 rounds and 60 seconds, that's fine. Just so you can get a little taste of the gameplay. And this is on a modded Game Boy. And there we go, that seems to be a little bit better. So with the backlighting. All right, I'm just gonna play, you know what, I'll play championship mode. Arcade mode is just one bout. Championship mode is numerous bouts, one after the other. I did stream this game with a capture device before, so, and I played as Afro Thunder. So let's play just as somebody else. If you saw that other video, let's play as S Strike, Susan Strike, I think, Celine Strike, excuse me. Okay, so I am rank 8, and I'm gonna try to get the rumble and the screen in one, so you can see how it shakes. You can see the vibration. So I'll turn this up. I'll let this play. So you get these Game Boy videos. This one's animated, but of course the announcer isn't, because that would just take too much memory. But it does have voiceover. Okay. Let's see if we can do this. Did I turn the rumble? Oh, rumble's off. Duh, I am so dumb. Okay, here, rumble's on. So now watch this up here, okay? So I guess I turned it off in the main menu. There we go. So every hit that you land, killed him. Winner. So if you can see that. So this Rumble Pak game, it's kind of just one-dimensional. There's really just one strength of Rumble. You hit him once and it's just the same amount of strength. Where there's other games, there's a small vibration, there's a bigger vibration, and I'll go over that in the other games that I'm going to cover in future videos. But this game, mostly one-dimensional. See the rumble motor moving in the background there, right? This game, maybe it was cooler back in 1999. It was also available on the Dreamcast, but not that great. You got right punch, you got left punch, and you can uppercut if you use up and down, and stomach punches if you hit down, and then you could block by hitting back. Very simple, nothing complicated. And then when rumble, you can skip this by hitting start, by the way. We're gonna skip this for the time being. And then, and you can see rumble is going to appear at the top. You know, it spells out rumble with each successful hit. You can hit back to block or dodge. And when rumble gets spelled out, all right, I'm gonna A and B, and now it goes, now you can kind of swing a little faster. I think punches do a little bit more damage. You can walk around them. You can go on the other side, but the AI is just pretty brutal. They just follow you no matter where you go. They're always just right on top of you. So this is just easy mode, but if you play this on the harder difficulties, you will get smoked. But it's kind of unfortunate. There's really no RPG mechanics. There's no, you know, there's no leveling up. You can't even play two-player Link mode. There are secret characters that you can unlock. So if you play Championship mode, and if you beat it on the different difficulties, they give you a code that you enter on the main menu, and then you can unlock a couple new characters depending on the difficulty that you beat it at. But other than that, the game just kind of, you can just button mash your way through, as I'm kind of doing right here. But the Rumble Pak is cool. I mean, it does add another dimension. In my other stream, it does lose a little something without the force feedback. So if you have the chance to play this with the Rumble Pak with a live battery, I recommend it. It's probably one of the better uses, I guess. But even though it's just the same strength of Rumble, but we're gonna go through all the games in time. I just, you know, we'll be putting more Rumble Pak videos together. This is just the first one at the time. Let's see if I can kill Afro Thunder. There, blocked one. Trying to go with the uppercuts. Keep your eye on that Rumble Pak motor at the top. I also recommend getting a modded Game Boy. Very cool. And you can see, you can just touch the IR to get different strengths. This is actually on the lowest, which picks up better on the camera here. All right. This will probably be my last fight. Let's see if I can kill the big guy. Defeat the big guy. Because you're not killing people in boxing games, right? All right, let's activate the rumble. Come on. All right, A and B, here we go. The blue bar at the bottom is your stamina, red bar is your health. All right, got him. I don't know if you can hear that too, but whenever there's the voice, you get a buzz, you get a humming noise. Let me see if you can listen to that. So listen to the announcer and you'll hear a slight buzz. I'm gonna be quiet. I don't know if it picked up on that, but there is like a hum, a buzz. So some of the Game Boy Color games, not just Rumble games, but because the sound, you know, on the system, not exactly the best thing in the world, especially when you have digitized voices and digitized sound effects, it's like too much for the system to handle, and you get this weird buzzing noise. But that's just the cartridge. Nothing's wrong with it. It just happens. Oh, will I beat him? All right, I just killed him. Chemo Claw. So I'm the winner now. And that should be the last guy, and then you get a password to unlock him. I'm in the Eastern Division. To unlock Chemo Claw, there you go. Use that code. Got it, write it down. That's it, and it just starts over again. It doesn't even take you back to the main menu. You can, by the way, in the middle of a match, like I demonstrated in the beginning of the video, if you hit start, you can pause it, and then you can turn the rumble on or off on the fly, but you can't go back to the main menu, which is you gotta just turn the power off. So that's Ready to Rumble Boxing. Again, pretty cool. The Rumble Pack. Rumble, there we go. Game Boy Color game. So let me know what you think. Do you have any Game Boy Color games that rumble? Do you want to see more of these types of videos? Let me know in the comments below. You could follow me on Twitter at Zach Gaz, ZACKGAZ. Please check out mygamer.com. Go to squallsnake.com. Check out all my other work there. Greatly appreciate it. So until next time, thank you for watching and game on.